Old man? You almost fell on the stairs, didn't you? Please be careful on the stairs. Thank you for caring about me, but don't treat me like an old man. That annoys me. Oops, sorry about that. Hey, kid, over there. What? Are you talking to me? Says Forte. Old men that say they are okay are more dangerous than anything. Please watch out for them. Okay, I will. I heard that, says McBean. Yes, please take a look at this. A guide, says? He was a guardsman, wasn't he? Who are all those people over there, says Forte. They are tourists. Why don't you go listen to what the guide has to say? Where are they? Oh. Serene says, I'm scared of heights. The guide says, this is the Grim Bridge, which is famous for being the biggest structure in Wout Luna. It's also the masterpiece of a dam type with built-in waterway, go-back-style bridge formation. Can people in the back hear me? The height of the Grim Bridge is 102 milos. It can hold up to 4,000 galettel. The hell's a galettel? It lives up to the name of the biggest dam in the world. These abundant waters run through the sluice of Ekjal and Kavaro, but flow not only to Marcheros, but also to Astern. They spelled Astern wrong. Please enjoy the scenic view here. I'm scared of height, says Serene. When I see this kind of scenery, it makes me want to jump down. Meepy says, wow, it's so high. By whom and when was such a huge thing built? I can answer that question, says the guide. It is said that the Grim Bridge was built around 100 years before the Gagarv calendar began. We don't know who built this, but we know that the whole set of facilities connecting to Kavara's elevated sluice was built around the same time. Eunice says, I bet carpenters were the ones who built it. Forte says, so Kavaro's elevated sluice was that old too? Eunice says, are you ignoring my jokes? The guide says, the ancient people might have possessed an advanced knowledge of technologies that we can't even imagine. Do you have any other questions? Serene says, yes, I have a question. Go ahead. In Marcheros, several facilities such as the elevated sluice in Kavaro have been preserved, but nothing's left in Astern? The guide says, it's too bad nothing's left there. We assume that sluices were running through Astern a long time ago, but there's not even a single piece of evidence. Also, this has nothing to do with the sluices, but the underground ruins still remain at Selbart in Astern. I didn't know that, says Serene. Okay, no more questions? That'll be the end of the tour, then. Thank you for taking the Grim Bridge tour. Okay, we'll talk to peoples. I'm scared of heights. I'm beside myself with fear. Yep, beside yourself. There's another one right next to you. And it's you. It's strange that we don't know anything about the people who built such a huge structure. We all usually know who is responsible for digging even a well. When my grandpa was young, he dug a community well, even though it was small. Even my cousin's neighbors in the next village know about that. Isn't that pretty usual? Unusual? Isn't that pretty usual? Shula says, are you guys troubadours? Yes, we're the McBean Company, says McBean. We just came here from Marcheros. Can you play by request? Yes, that's my job. I've always wanted to make a request at least once. Usually when I'm in the village, I think of making requests for musicians as a rich person's privilege. But once I go on a trip, I lose perspective, and it makes me want to spend money like the rich. I can totally understand that, says Forte. All right, I'll give you a special treat, says McBean. Yes. Okay, says Forte. Besides, it must be fun to play on the Grim Bridge. You've already done it. We'll play Sun Through Trees. Oh, just a solo harp song. Bravo, says Eunice. Serene says, good job, wonderful. Shula says, awesome. Mippy says, that totally stole my heart. Glad that everyone liked it, Luna said. McBain says, I feel like I can do this for free once in a while, if we can receive such a big applause. Oh no, says Shula, I feel bad if you do it for free. It's not much, but please accept this. 14 and his friends receive 100 gent. Are you sure it's okay? Asked Forte. Just to show my appreciation. Then, thank you, says McBain. Thanks a lot, really, Shula says. I feel like I finally fulfilled my dream to spend money in a royal style. In a royal style, huh? Nothing new there. Still filled with fear. Still, don't know. Pretty usual. My long-term dream to ask the traveling musicians to play for me has finally been fulfilled. Oh, I finally accomplished it. My heart is too full for words. And then he starts crying. McBain says he's overreacting a bit much. Each person has his own dream to fulfill, right? Says Forte. We haven't talked to Mippy yet. If I stand in a high place, my stomach feels like it's tightening. Oh yeah, squeeze! La 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 la. Okay. These people are kind of out of it. Oh hi, who are you? Alenti says, wow, it's so astounding to think about building such a huge thing. My puny head can't even imagine what it was like. My puny little head. I don't think I can even try to explain to my family when I go home. I want to come back here with my family next time. Servia says, how do you do? Are you here for a tour? We are troubadours, says Forte. We are from Letteratudo, Una says. You came that far. Astrid is much harder than any other place. Please be careful not to consume your energy too much. I pray that your journey will be fruitful in Astern. Thanks, says McBain. I'm a Marcherose native. My job is to distribute items from Marcherose to this toolsman. My greatest pleasure is to see the scenery after work. Dix says, I was longing to come visit this bridge for a long time, and it finally came true. This is truly amazing. Nothing can compare to this scenery and great architecture. The Grim Bridge is the great heritage from our ancestors. Shand says, my wife and I are traveling in commemoration of our 10th wedding anniversary. Oh, are we going to play for their wedding anniversary now? We would love to go visit the desert after this. We're not playing for them? Wow, guess we're all played out. Karko says, he asked me what I wanted for our 10th wedding anniversary, so I told him I wanted a memory I could cherish. I will take this magnificent scenery of the Grim Bridge into my heart forever. I mean, really, it's kind of a cheapskate. It's just buy you a ring, some flowers. I mean, I was thinking the same thing of the other guy. The one that just, they just got married. I mean, they could both give each other better presents than just looking at scenery. I heard that. Oh, another checkpoint. Let's scope out the perimeter. Daring says, the guardsman who is patrolling over there is a kind of guy who is too square. I bet he is a good person, though, but... he's hip to be square, I don't know. Hi, you walk fast. All serene. If something happens, let me know. I'll take care of it immediately. I'm such a hard worker. Hicks says, okay, we got Dix and Hicks. I'm on my way to Cavaro. The rumor says that the Numero's army has conquered Cavaro. I don't feel safe, so I'm just observing from this checkpoint. You came from that side? What's really going on? You can't observe Cavaro from here. You might want to stay here a little longer, says Forte. McBain says, Cavaro is not totally conquered by Numero's, but it's true that they reign supreme. But the people in Cavaro are pretty tough. I think the Numero's army will be driven away soon. Really? That's good to hear. Then I'm going to stay here for a while to see how things will go. It sucks that the conditions of the country changes during the trip. You have no idea how much I'm spending on accommodations. Una says, look, there's a guide there. Forte says, are you talking about the Grim Bridge every day to the people who pass by? Yes. It's a hard job, isn't it? Asks Una. Forte says, I would get sick of talking about the same thing over and over. Don't you feel like talking about something else once in a while? Yeah, I have my moments. But I like being a guide here because I get to meet many people. I'm worried about what the Numero's is up to lately. If a war starts, people won't have time to do things such as traveling. That's true. I'm going to be afraid to travel into a dangerous area. We don't need to stay at the inn. You don't need any passing procedure here. This checkpoint is conducted by guardsmen who have been transferred from Marcheros. If you've already received permission at the east checkpoint of Grim Bridge, you don't have to do anything here. It'll be pretty far from here to the oasis, so this place is kept open for travelers who want to rest. I would feel bad about telling them to go back on the Grim Bridge if they wanted to take a rest. You just, what, lay on the... on the bridge? And try to go to sleep that way? D'Amigo says, I was curious to see what you're selling, but I can find better items at the bazaar in the oasis. I guess this is the best a toolsman at the checkpoint can do. Ooh! Dollar Knight 17, the boy became a man. Took one of that. And we don't need this other stuff. Sweet, though. This is all the stuff that's at the other checkpoint. I guess Ada could use a sword or armor. Yeah. That's 6 points of defense. So tell the chest guard also and the ring armor. Cool. All right. Watch your steps. Did you say anything to me? Says McBain. No, to that lady over there. Una and Ada says, thanks. To me, right? Says Ada. I don't know. What do you mean by don't know? You all please be careful with your step. Is he afraid of McBain or something? I'm interested in hypnotism. Random. If I keep staring at fire, my eyes start to flicker. And then you feel more heat from the fire, and my brain starts to zone out. You get sleepy because you're bored. And I drop dead and wake up. I like the moment because I feel like I overcame my own hypnotism. It's a bit weird, says McBain. Bunch of barrels. Did we hit something? It felt like... I heard like a crunk. I don't know. Okay. Just making sure I see everyone and everything. Yellow Sand Way. Oasis is west, 553 Milos. Yeah, they're afraid because we have the noise bell on. Still love the footprints. That's a funky tune, isn't it? Should we take part in one of these? I mean, we've gotten better. Why not? The tuning fork resonated in harmony, and the light wrapped Forte and his friends. And I bypassed the last one, maybe the one before that as well. With your level now, you can try until this point. And then a new encounter. Let's try, because I know we did this, right? And then we did the ship. Scotia Shrine, not sure if he finished. Let's try the Scotia Shrine. Can't really get past you, can I? Okay. I hit one. Oh! I don't have, I gotta switch back to Forte. I forgot about that. We got a Tagos, a Hazaman, and two Lacerda dragons. I'll save, yeah, for the battle. We took care of that one quickly. Alright, everyone get Lacerda Dragon A. Can't reach. She can reach. Eh, bloop. We found a spellbook 3 and hunter book 2. Spellbook 3. Adventures book published in Elfilden. You become an expert of sleep spells. This is an expert of defense spells. This is boomerang techniques, and this is never missing targets. All from Elfilden, which is a Tear of a Million land. Alright, we'll fight the big guy. And water spirits. I feel like just taking care of the spirits first. C. Nope. 406 points. I'm gonna try to only interrupt Scotia. Herself, I guess? Let's get a Water Spirit A then. One left. Rock crash. Wow. We got a bandit book too. Yes, I made it, says Forte. I see that you had a great training, says McBean. Let's come back here together, Forte, Una says. No, we don't need to come back here. We'll go to the other ones. Woof, woof, and squeak. It was a great fun, says Ada. Let's do this together again. Well, she just sit on the sidelines and watch us, though. I'm gonna check out that bandit book. Bandit book 2. Gain first class skills of rods. I guess that's the one we found. Okay. Let's save. I think that was pretty easy. We should be able to handle the next one, right? There's two more. The Eden Shrine we'll do next. Yeah, we're completely undamaged by this. We could fight these things to get our special attacks up a little bit more. Just in case that might be needed. Because all we have is Charge Dog right now. Which Charge Dog is awesome, but we're a little bit more special attacks on that. Rabius. Two Hinoviuses. And two Vidartha Dragons. No, we can't reach. Let's get this Rabius thing now. Magic shield. I do not approve of your magic shield or your poison. No, I really don't approve of it. Get the high. I just want to see if we have a magic way. One ally is detoxified. That sounds like something good for... recovery? Alright, we'll try Contalact on McBain and see if that does that. The trick. The rest of us will attack this Hinovius thing. Something to clean your heart. Purge, she said. Okay, good. We didn't have to use any item for it. Ouch. One left. Be hitting our dog, you're toast now, buddy. Dog bites back. Well, that's a lot better. Now we got Bandit Book 1. I think we just have to hold these things. You can use daggers skillfully. Banged up, huh? Now, if... I guess we could go back by hitting that. I just want to fight the boss, really. I'll be dealing with these endless enemies. I'm gonna throw in a separate save. Just to get in case I want to try again, but I don't want to fight that thing. I just do this. Eden and Wind Spirit. Alright, so... attacking Wind Spirit B, whoever can reach anyway. I'll interrupt Eden. And Eden only, unless I mess up. Here we go. Cool. Attack this one A here. A little more central, everyone can reach. He's got his. His special attack, Forte. Charge dog. See if Eden ever gets to go. Still working on the one, whatever, Wind Spirit, yeah. The puppy. And puppy attack. We got one more special attack we can use. We destroyed one of those things. Awesome. Not so fast, mister. Electro cube. Ouch. I don't know if he should just try to take down Eden now. Gonna be more I don't know how many points it has. It's gonna be more. We've done more damage to it than the Wind Spirit. I Yeah, I'll have her do this. All heal. Seven points. What does it do now? Paralysis powder, and it missed. Oh, it missed someone, but hit someone else. Okay. Oh, crap. Oh, and she didn't get to cast her healing. Just like it knew. Funny how the dog can use items. Alright, let's see if there's something really good we can use here. Fresh bread. Won't feel drowsy. Ryutam pie, okay. She's paralyzed. So this cures... This would cure it. Unless... What if I s... What if... Oh, I can't switch her. I can't switch her, because I can't control her. Alright, I was gonna switch Una out for Ada, but it doesn't work that way. Well... Forte goes pretty quick, right? So, let's see... Purify potion. That's poison. That's paralysis. Lackety paste? Alright. Alright, so... Heal her. McBain will hit Eden. And, So I wonder if he had a good spell, but I'm not sure. Alright. Okay, and then Pararin cure for Una. So hopefully she'll be joining back the party after this round. 999 points she gets back. She's back! That was a rude awakening. Confusion? No one confused? That's wonderful. Shall we try this again? The all heal? Soon we can start interrupting Eden again. And that'll make things easier. Oh, we killed him! Oh, we didn't have to fight that other spirit. McBain, level 26, has learned Sixth Sense. He sees dead people. Una has learned Shadow Stitch. Forte has learned Rhythmical. And Jan and Richten learned Crap. Awesome. Yes, I made it. This is the same thing they say. They say that for the same thing for, I guess, every At the end of every scenario? Now you know the next one's gonna be insane, right?